I truly appreciate you watching until the end, but as always, I will get straight to the point now with details later. The Halo T16 is just so-so when it comes to noise cancellation, but it's not a complete dud. There's a never-before-seen outdoor mode that eliminates wind noise, which will be very handy if you use it often on a windy day or on a bike ride. But it is far from perfect, so we're going to talk all about it starting right now. Selamat pagi! Good morning everyone, Kenneth here, and today we're checking out the Halo T16, the company's first generation ANC buds that retails for $60. I bet a lot of you have been waiting for this review, so I want to start by talking about the pricing first, because the Halo T16 competes against some crazy good earbuds in this price range. There's Edifier NB2 at 80 bucks. This is Earphone Air Pro, same thing. Or my top rated Feel T1 Pro at 64 bucks. I'll leave affiliate links in the description below if you want to support the channel, but yeah, I really only recommend getting the Halo T16 for a couple of reasons. One, you don't want to import from AliExpress, you have it in your local specific region. Two, it goes at a lower price in your specific region. Or three, you see it discounted to 50 bucks like this one, because only then I could somewhat justify the purchase. Now, I've put disclaimers down in the description below, and as with all my full reviews, you are getting my own honest opinion, so don't forget to hit the thumbs up so more people could see this video and subscribe for more reviews in the future. Let's get started with the first part, the sound quality. This is Halo's first foray into the sub-$100 market. As a first-gen product, I think it sounds fine. It's got a pretty good soundstage, but it's quite a flat sound. So you get neither punchy bass nor forward vocals. And with this sound, I just don't know what to get excited about, honestly. But let's talk about my review songs. You can find a link down in the description below if you want to listen for yourself. We're going to start with Don't Stop Me Now by Queen. And comparing this to the Earphone Air Pro, which is the same thing as Edifier NB2, not gonna repeat that, it's immediately noticeable that the bass is stronger and vocals are more forward and detailed. Furthermore, it's louder as well. Though it's not so much of a problem, unlike the Soundbeat Sonic. But then, to Halo's credit, the soundstage is marginally better here. So imagine this song with just enough bass, warm vocals that are put on the same plane as the instruments, but then spread out to the sides. That is how the Halo T16 sounds. Well, then comes the Feel T1 Pro with even more detail, even more treble, with arguably the same amount of soundstage to the Halo T16. This could be a good thing or a bad thing depending on your preference. Due to the toned down vocals, the Halo T16 will make sure that the song will never sound harsh. But the Feel T1 Pro, on the other hand, as I've said in this full review, hurts a lot. But that's how a crash cymbal will sound in real life. It has that sparkle and detail that is nowhere to be seen on a Halo, but I still think this is worthy of a comparison in this type of song. Now, in this next song by Yoroshika, this is where the Halo T16 falls apart and really get destroyed by the other earbuds. The tuning makes it sound crowded, like you boost the lower mids too high without balancing the trebles out, and that makes for comparison the Earphone Air Pro to sound more dynamic, and best of all, the Feel T1 Pro, hands down, the best out of the three here. The bass kicks, the vocals, the cymbal crashes, everything sounds like they're playing on a 1080p video compared to a blurry 360p one. I think complicated songs like this are where the Halo T16 struggles the most. Fortunately though, it sounds just fine when playing pop, rap, electronic songs. Just keep in mind that you might find the bass to not reach as deep or punch as strong as you might want. With that said, I think it sounds okay, but it's just barely there as a passing mark, you know? Now, moving on to build quality and features, I won't take too much time. This is the best quality out of a Halo product yet, which actually means it's on par for the price. You can see my initial impression in my unboxing video, like the softness of the case. One LED battery indicator here, USB-C and wireless charging support, as well as the 600 mAh battery inside. It is pretty well done. I just wish there would be some resistance to keep the lid open when tilted all the way like this, but it's not like it easily closes by itself, so for the most part, it's fine. Just keep in mind that soft materials like this tend to get scuffed up pretty easily. Now onto the earbuds. This is IPX5 water resistant. It's well made, the battery life lives up to the claim. It's fine, but using it always feels off. Like at first I couldn't find a secure fit, so I thought my largest spin fit tips could help, but it felt exactly the same. It's insecure, it's not tight enough, but I quickly realized that it stays just fine, so I kind of got used to how it fits basically. Then another problem surfaces. I found the wear detection sensor to be way too sensitive, or rather, it doesn't have a window period, so whenever it detects anything close, like I grab it accidentally or put it on a table or something, it will immediately react. And I don't know how many times I get annoyed with my music abruptly playing and pausing unwantedly because of this. Though on the bright side, when you take the earbuds out, the music pauses almost immediately, so there's less friction when you need to suddenly talk to someone. But I don't know, I'm not a big fan of wear detection in general, so maybe use two sensors to really, really detect when the earbud is in your ear or something. Now my next problem is with the controls. As you can see here, there are some missing controls, and I have a ton of whys here. Starting with the triple tap gesture. Why only game mode? And why only on the right side? Why not balance it out with A and C on the left side? Why sacrifice previous song? And where is my volume control? Whatever the reason is, maybe to make it easier to switch A and C modes, you know, double tap instead of triple tap, but is it worth it? I can't even switch to transparency mode from this ANC toggling thing, you know? And especially the lack of volume controls is just unacceptable in this price range. Now yes, with the app, I can change single tap on both sides to volume control, but I need to make yet another sacrifice and fully rely on the wear detection sensor that I just complained. This is just too much, and also the app. It still doesn't offer anything more than just the battery case info. In my honest opinion, that's the only useful thing. Listen, Halo, why not open it up and let people customize 1, 2, 3 taps and hold gesture? That would go a long way in fixing this problem, but unfortunately, it still won't solve the entire problem because the touch sensor frequently misses a lot of my taps. Now, I understand this is not easy to perfect, but we consumers only care about usability and reliability. I think the easiest fix would be to put a physical button like how it is on Halo GT2. Put in volume control and we're good. Why mess with accelerometers like on T19 or struggle with the sensitivity on GT5 and now this? I sincerely hope you take this as an input from someone that wants you to be better. Anyway, let's talk about the ANC now. And as I've said, it's just so-so. I could have differentiated well in my unboxing video because the room was quiet then, but now that I got to use it more, I think it's only a bit better than a standard silicone fit on the Hyphen 2. I know, crazy to even say, but seriously, it performs below Feel T1 Pro, definitely below Earfun Air Pro or Transmart Apollo Bolt. It just doesn't reduce fan or AC noise considerably. The low rumbles in public places are still there, and the voices of people speaking will sound just the same with only their bass taken out a little bit. It's something that we Indonesians say, gili gili. I don't think it's a coincidence that I found their own graphs to visualize my findings quite accurately. You can see that just wearing the earbuds would reduce noise passively to the red line, and what the ANC does is take out a bit of that low mid to upper bass region, but mostly the low rumbles at 20Hz and the upper mid above 2kHz stay pretty much the same. Now I'm nowhere near the expert when it comes to audio frequency stuff, I just did my research to talk about it. But what I can't quite understand is I found human vocals to be in the 85 to 255Hz region, which should be decreased a lot in this graph, right? Why am I not experiencing it? It really feels like people sound just as loud with ANC off with their bass cut off. Now, touching a bit on the outdoor mode, this one performs around 90% of the full-on ANC mode, but it perfectly cancels out wind noise, which is great. Now, as I've said, this could be the deciding factor if you interact with wind a lot in your day, as even the Earfun Air Pro has problems with wind noise. That's just the way it is for budget ANCs I've tested so far. until this outdoor mode. As for the transparency mode, I honestly thought the outdoor mode was transparency mode until I realized there is a separate mode hidden inside the app. You heard that right, you cannot toggle between ANC and transparency on the earbuds itself. You need to go to the app every time. Why? I've said it in my collab with Peaky Audio, I value good transparency mode and oftentimes I even use it more than the ANC, but this is already making it hard to use. Speaking of the quality itself, it gets the job done. It opens up a bit of the upper frequencies and lets me talk to people, and if I'm making a phone call that helps too, but it uses the mic down here, so expect rubbing noise when you touch it accidentally, and it has quite some hiss. Honestly, you can ignore all that if you use it in anything but a quiet room. But the problem is, if there's anything loud happening, they have an anti-clipping feature that activates the transparency mode for a second on that specific side. Let's talk about it in a practical way. These loud noises from closing doors, snapping fingers, small bumps and crashes that happen often when we're out and about, they have the potential to trigger one side of your ear but to turn off for a second and you'll feel like you're half deaf, which is unpleasant. And I would bet without this protection, the finger snap or whatever it is that happened would not damage my hearing in any way. This is not a loud transparency mode by any means, so this feature is a big no-no. Anyway, let's check out the latency test and the microphone test right now. Alright, so welcome to the call test, everyone. Right now you're listening to the Halo T16, and this is kind of an indoor setting where nothing is going on. Right now, let's turn on a crowd noise, and this is it with the crowd noise turned on. It's playing off of my MacBook Pro 16 at 100% volume, which is quite loud, and I think mimics what will happen in real life in a busy supermarket or in a shopping mall, for example. So yeah, this is how it sounds for the cable clearly. And that's pretty much it for the process. Let's get back to the video. In the end, the Halo T16 is no doubt a first-gen product that has small quirks here and there that piles up and makes it hard to recommend at its retail price, $60. Try to get a discount. Temper your expectations. It's the most feature-packed Halo to date, but it's just not there yet. Anyway, let me know what you think about it. I especially wanted to know your opinions if you've got one already. And don't forget to hit the thumbs up, subscribe. I'm Kenneth. I will see you in the next one. Bye.